The audio, there we are. Thank you so much for having me. And let me just dive straight into everything that we should be doing. Can we switch on the slides, please? Yes, there we are. I've just gotten out my book, and Carlo Petrini, Carlo, you were the one who told me, write that book. So then I got back to you and said, you write the foreword. Thank you, Carlo, for making that possible. It's the first day the book is available. You know, when you see a forest like this, I want you to be inspired by nature. In a forest, no one is unemployed. Everyone has a job. Migrants are welcome. And in a forest like that, there's no waste. You know, we sometimes forget the incredible productive capacity of nature, provided we go beyond the animals and the plants. The fungi kingdom can produce so many more nutritions for us. And why is there no massive farming of mushrooms? Like here, my daughter, this lady is my daughter. Her name is Chido. I adopted her when she was 11. And Chido is telling these women on a coffee farm in Chipinge in Zimbabwe that it is possible to take the waste from the farm and transform that into mushrooms within 2 weeks. Why worry about plants and animals? 2 weeks, and you know, when the women learn that within 2 weeks they can have mushrooms, you know what they do? They get up, they sing, they dance, and they do it. You know what the Europeans want and the Americans want? A business plan. A technology audit. We want to have a commission to decide about the future. No. Africa has a tradition of mushroom farming and we've forgotten it. Why don't we do it? My organization, in 1994, helped prepare COP3. We're COP23. We're still preparing. We still haven't done anything. We have 200 projects implemented, and what I would like to share with you is that when you are able to implement so many things, it's because you're inspired. There are people who inspire you by doing things. We have 3,000 scientists. We have 1,000 entrepreneurs. We bridge the science with the entrepreneurship, and we move on to transform. We need to innovate. We need to create value with what we have, but it's going to have to be disruptive. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in dire need of a few Che Guevaras, but not with the guns, not with the bullets. But we need to be revolutionaries in what we're doing, and we need to be surprising. We need to surprise people with what is possible. When you go to Patagonia and you look at this forest, what do you see in this forest? What is the greatest biodiversity you observe in this forest? It's yeast. Yeast. Lievre. Lievi. Lievito. Levadura. This is what you find here, because if you're in Patagonia and you're in the Himalayas, you have the two largest regions of the world that still have wild yeast. What do we need yeast for? Well, first of all, for a good beer. You need it for bread. You need it for your wine. Yeast is in every home, but 99.9% of all yeast used today is genetically modified, and we never thought about it. We can organize in Patagonia yeast safaris. You can go and find your yeast and make your own bread, your own beer, your own wine. It's possible. You can recover by being positive. Ladies and gentlemen, in spite of all the bad news we hear, do we have the strength here to be positive? If we're not able to listen to the negative and use that energy to be positive, this world is over. So let's look at this here. As we all know, the maritime sector got excluded from the Paris Agreement. This is why. But I'm now starting the tour around the world with this boat. The first boat in the world that goes around the world with hydrogen generated with solar power out of salt water. And our byproduct, ladies and gentlemen, is water. Are you ready to join the boat? Are you ready to get on the ship? And our backup is a kite. This is the kind of breakthrough thinking we need. We need to be disruptive but positive. And in the process, let's enjoy what we're doing. I love pigs. But somehow the industry kills the pigs at 6 months of age. Why? You know, the pigs love to live together with the chickens. They adore each other. Why? Because the chicken will eat all the parasites. You want a healthy pig, you better get the chickens on there. But in Germany, with Karl Ludwig Schweinfurt, he has these houses. And the pigs live on the ground floor. And mind you, installing a toilet. Because pigs learn in 3 days how to go to the toilet. Now, if you have a clean pig, you have saved 40% of the cost of maintaining your pigs. It took me a little longer than 3 days to know to go to the toilet. The pigs in three. But on the top floor live the chickens. Because in the winter time, our chickens don't lay so many eggs because it's too cold, but the pigs keep them warm. Warm pigs, warm chickens, clean pigs. Productivity is high. This is where Mr. Schweinfurt lives. It's a castle. Why do we want to press the money out of our farmers for always cheaper chickens and always cheaper pork meat? This is insane. You know, when a pig lives for 1 year, it produces more omega-3 than genetically we can push into the salmon in Norway. Who wants Norwegian salmon with omega-3 that comes from overfishing in Peru with anchovies and herrings? Who wants that? Just let your pig live a year and you have more omega-3. It is simple. I mean, we live in a world of fantasy. So I am forced to write fables so people can see the reality. We should not continue. Let's talk about a cup of coffee. I mean, this is Italy, right? Segafredo, Illy, Lavazza. You are the coffee roasters of the world. But did you know that all the coffee waste from industrial processing of coffee in Vietnam is now processed into textiles? Textiles which allow you to use the geometry of coffee. Because coffee has an amazing physical feature that coffee in the first place absorbs your odor, as our grandmother knew it because she put it into the refrigerator. It gives you fast drying, saving energy, and it protects you from ultraviolet. We can do coffee, mushrooms, food, textiles. We can do carpets. We can do insulation material. We can even do paints with coffee. If you want to make money for the farmer, don't just think coffee to drink. Think coffee as a textile, coffee as a biochemical. Coffee as a biochemical is sold for $3,000 a ton. Organic fair trade coffee is sold for barely $800 a ton. Are we ready to give the farmer more revenue using what we don't consume? Then we have this interesting strategy of only work with green beans. I have been shocked with the packaging of the food industry. We need to urgently do something about it. So we created a partnership with a very unlikely company called Melita. People thought Melita was at the end of their life. We're using expensive capsules from Nespresso these days. This is what we do. We take the Melita, put a little chip in there, and that chip tells us exactly at the farm where the coffee came from. We're doing big data with filters because we're shipping green beans, and so we needed to change the machinery. We now have the coffee machine that roasts, grinds, and brews. And in every little pouch, we know exactly where it came from. And from every brew, we know how you like it to be roasted. We got big data on coffee. But it allows us to pay the farmer 4 times more. Because we save all the money on the packaging and all the intermediation that is there. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not difficult to change things around. This machine is on the market. We only do it in Germany. We don't do it elsewhere. But what is important is that this is an old brand called Melita that is being transformed into big data for the service of the farmer. Disintermediating all the way. And guess what? Big data is changing tremendously because all of you are still working with your internet in the old way. Ladies and gentlemen, every single light here can be transformed into a satellite. Big data that goes over your cell phone and over the satellites is controlled by Google, controlled by Amazon, controlled by 5 American corporations, and we have nothing to say about it. I'm tired of that. I want my data back. I deserve that, so I need to change the medium, and the medium is changed. Because Wi-Fi gives it away, we now have Li-Fi, light-based internet. Light-based internet is a reality. There are 14 billion light points in the world, which all can become like a satellite. This is the revolution. This is how we can keep track of every food around the world, with light. And light is natural. In the metro of Paris, La Défense, we can make the blind people walk through the metro already, only with a telephone, because your telephone already works on light, but you didn't know it. We can park you exactly where the free parking space is with a light system. We can actually tell you where the pasta is in the supermarket, and you can put your Barilla pasta, and you, since the light gives you a 1 centimeter precise position, not like the GPS with meters of error, 1 centimeter precise, I can put in front of the Barilla row. That is big data of the future. It can be done today. Why aren't you doing this? Every street light becomes a satellite. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the revolutions we're looking at. This is 4-0 radio waves. And did you know that 60% of the people have a shopping list, don't find what they're looking for, and therefore don't buy it? You know what it is in distribution, having 4% more turnover? 80% energy savings? Oh, and by the way, we're saving energy. 80%. And it's 200 times faster than Wi-Fi. Why don't we know this? Because Cisco doesn't want you to know. Because the big data doesn't want you to know. Because if you know, you're ruining their business model. Ladies and gentlemen, I am the Che Guevara in a reincarnation. Orange peels. I find this amazing around the world. Everywhere, every cafe has this machine to make fresh orange juice. And what do we do with the peels? Nothing. With the peels, This was my factory in Belgium. I was making the first biodegradable soaps in 1991, but I realized I was using palm oil. I was destroying the face of the earth with my palm oil. But now, everyone at home, you can take 1 kilogram of citrus peels, 1 liter of water, and 7 spoons of sugar. Don't put the sugar in your coffee, put the spoons in the detergent. You close it up, 3 weeks later you have detergents. Let's bankrupt Procter & Gamble, will you finally? Let's do something serious, not by being against them, but by being smarter and being positive and empowering people. That's the way to go forward. And of course I wrote a fable about that. My last example is from Italy. I have the great honor to be the chairman of an Italian company called Novamont. This is cardo. These are thistles. Roundup and glyphosates have been trying to kill it for 40 years. Never succeeded. It always comes back. I mean, it's good if you're in the glyphosate business because you can do for 40 years as if you are successful. Now comes nature's revenge. The cardo actually has the chemicals to substitute the glyphosates. We're the only large-scale producer of substitutes for glyphosates. Il cardo. The Roundup tried to kill cardo, now cardo will kill Roundup. Wow! This is what we need. On top of that, we can make the plastics, we can make the capsules for the coffee, the lubricants, and the elastomers. Ladies and gentlemen, on the cardo is a little white dust, and that little white dust is a bacterial enzyme which in Sardinia you need to make goat cheese. We didn't know we have 2,000 tons of it. We can do all the goat cheese in the whole of Italy with our 2,000 tons of bacterial enzymes from cardo, which is a byproduct from our glyphosate substitute. Are we ready to transform society? And on top of that, we're doing it in the old facility, the old petrochemical facility of Eni Importadores. My last case is a plea with you. When we're thinking about farming, we have to stop thinking about 2D, tons per hectare. An apple from Piemonte in the mountains has 20 times more nutrition, vitamins and fibers than the imported Chilean apple. 20 times. And then you're debating the price? I don't get it. Why are you debating the price per kilo? Why don't we debate the price per nutrition? But we don't know that with apples. But this is the future. 70% of our world is covered by the sea. And if you farm 3D, as described by Science Magazine, we're able to produce 1,000 tons of biomass per hectare, 3 meters deep per year. Why do we mess around with genetics? Why do we mess around with chemistry when you can only get to 25 tons per hectare, whereas in the sea you can get to 1,000 tons? When humanity's brain started evolving, it was because the humanities started to feed themselves on the sea. The future of food, ladies and gentlemen, is the sea. Because with a high density and the three-dimensionality, productivity is unparalleled with what genetics and chemistry can ever promise you. But we're using, first of all, the seaweed to break the back of shale gas. I don't want energy to come from the fracking from the undergrounds. I want it to come from where the productivity is the best. I'm not against GMO. I'm not against fracking. I'm in favor of much better. Ladies and gentlemen, can we take the culture of getting in the mindset of just doing always better? Biogas from seaweeds is the equivalent of $8 a barrel for petroleum. Why would we debate shale gas after all? Why would we even debate it? Italy, you don't have a bit of extra algae in Venice? You don't have a bit of excessive seaweeds here and there? Mediterranean? The Mediterranean can produce all the seaweed it needs to produce all the natural gas to substitute Russia and Algeria. You have it. Why don't you do it? And I think this is what we need to have. Fantasy. Fantasy to imagine solutions that today seem to be impossible. But the reality is very different. And ladies and gentlemen, to conclude, that's why I have to write fables and children's stories. Because we adults, we live in a world of fantasy. The world we're living on is an unreal world. We need to come back to the real world. And the beauty of children is that they will never make a distinction between fantasy and reality. Everything for a child is reality. We adults, it's about time we get out of our fantasy world and get our feet back on the ground and move forward. Thank you very much.